Good evening and welcome to tonight's debate. This is the first debate in a series of discussions entitled The New Economy of Art, organized jointly by Artquest, the Contemporary Arts Society, and DACS. My name is Gilane Tawadros, and I'm the Chief Executive of DACS, and I'm delighted to welcome you here tonight. Tonight's debate is entitled, What Are We Worth? Artists and the Economic Crisis. Crisis is a much overused word, but it just may be an understatement in the current economic times we're living. And although I'd personally become inured, as maybe some of you have, to the predictions of imminent doom in the financial pages of The Guardian, when the rather cautious and conservative Mervyn King, governor of the Bank of England, observed that this was the worst economic crisis since the Depression, I started to suspect that it actually might be far worse than the politicians and policymakers were prepared to admit. Tonight, we'll be avoiding Greek debt and the imminent collapse of the euro, and we'll be concentrating on the impact of what must surely be now an economic Armageddon, then, on artists and their capacity to sustain a livelihood and a practice through the turbulent times ahead. While, and I'm sure those of you who are there also may not have discerned any whiff of recession, let alone economic crisis at the Frieze Art Fair last week, the anecdotal evidence from artists across the UK is that they're starting to feel the very severe impacts of recession and public funding cuts. The last time that Britain suffered a recession in the late 80s and early 90s, artists demonstrated extraordinary resilience, imagination, and creativity, creating the spaces and means for themselves to make, show, and sell work. The current crisis will undoubtedly act as a platform for the energy, innovation, and sheer chutzpah of British artists, but it's also going to be a very significant challenge. So our question tonight is, how can artists address this challenge? And I'm delighted to welcome three very distinguished speakers. First to speak, on my right, will be John Kieffer, who will be giving a keynote address to kick off the discussion. John has over 25 years of experience in cultural policy, arts funding, and creative programming. He's worked with hundreds of arts organisations and held senior posts at the British Council and Greater London Arts, among many others. My favourite description of him, though, was on somebody's blog, who described John as a great guy with a big brain. Responding to John's keynote talk from an artistic perspective will be two extraordinary artists. The term global artist could have been invented with Zineb Sedira in mind. She lives and works across three countries and two continents and consistently makes exquisite and profoundly moving works which provocatively explore themes of movement, migration, and displacement. Bob and Roberta Smith, the single gentleman at the end, is an artist who has consistently challenged established ideas about creativity and artistic practice, producing compelling and lyrical works which challenge the status quo. Most recently, he's gone head-to-head with Michael Gove, Secretary of State for Education, challenging his ideology and education policy, and perhaps less contentiously, his dress sense. So, our first speaker is John Kieffer.